Welcome to SANFL TV, Mark. Obviously finished 2018 with a fair bit of momentum, winning the last six matches. Hopeful you can sort of carry that through to 2019.
Well, we hope we can, yeah. I mean, it was a really good way to finish the season, and, you know, it gave us a lot of things to take away from the year with that sort of finish, in the sense that it gave us a bit of validation that the game plan stands up, and that the personnel we have are capable, and also that our training standards had lifted enough to prepare us well enough to win those sorts of games. So it was a really good way to finish the season, and there's many benefits to that, but we have to be really careful now that we don't just think that will roll on for us, and we have to make that happen again and bring those efforts back to life, because wins are really underpinned by effort. So yeah, we've got to make sure we do the work.
That being said, in terms of expecting it to roll on, what do you learn from that first year in charge and your first year in the SANFL Statewide Super League that you can bring into year two?
I think the biggest takeaway for me was just how efficient you have to be with your training planning and the days that you have the players, because they're semi-professional, if you like, or part-time. You don't have them all that often, so you've got to really be really efficient with what you pack into your sessions, and make sure that you get enough education and the balance with the workload in terms of physical output, but also filling up the mental bucket as well. And planning that well in advance is one of the things that's really key in terms of getting that balance right.
You must have been pleased with the way you're able to tighten up your defence, in particular as the year wore on last year.
Certainly was. That was a real key focus in the mid part of the season, that we were leaking too many easy goals. And I think from even the loss against Centrals with 7 weeks out, I think they only scored 70 or thereabouts, and really no one scored over 70 against us except Sturt in the last game, but we were able to kick enough goals to win. And so, yeah, that was a real key piece of our game plan that came together in the second half of the year.
Recruiting-wise, you really bolstered your midfield nicely with the acquisition of Luke Partington and also Cory Gregson from AFL list, so you must be delighted with that.
Really thrilled to have both those guys on our list and with us now. And we were target-specific with our recruiting. We just didn't throw the net out far and wide. We wanted some real spread through the midfield. We feel like we've got some really good ball winners in Snook and Sawford and those types of players that get in and under, but we wanted a bit of outside legs and some spread. And both those guys, you know, Cory and both Luke and Cory bring that spread for us.
And really nice to welcome back Liam McBean and Brad Agnew to the footy club, familiar faces, and particularly Aggers, the fans love him.
Yeah, we all love him. He's a 100-game player, and he's one of those guys that puts the jumper on and plays with heart and passion. And Liam's been really impressive over the pre-season, and we're looking forward to seeing what he can bring to us and add another dimension, both ruck and forward.
This time of year, always some youngsters who bob up on the track and catch your eye. Who's sort of impressed you in the trials to date and might push up for round one?
Oh, look, there's a few guys. I think Finn Betterman's had a really good pre-season. He's a under-18 kid that's come up, played state footy last year. Seb Kerrish is 2 years out of under-18s, but has, again, a really good runner and played some really good football in the pre-season games and trials. And probably the other one's a young kid, McDermott, who's quite raw still, but an elite runner and quite a good reader of the game. So we've just got to develop him a little bit and maybe put him in the gym as well.
Yeah.
Not that I can talk, Zach, but put him in the gym and get him ready for senior football, and he might surprise a few.
And he's a relative of club great Chris McDermott too.
Yeah, I believe he's his nephew, but they're different builds.
Yeah, very different.
But he's a tough kid, yeah. So I'm sure he'll handle it when he gets a chance.
Well, Mark, thanks very much for your time on SANFL TV. All the best in 2019.
Cheers, Zach. Thanks.
Welcome to SANFL TV, Luke. How have you settled back into Adelaide life?
Yeah, I'm loving it back here in Adelaide. I've been back here since October, so loving it, settling in, and just started uni now. So footy season's not far away, so things will start getting busy very shortly.
Obviously, several clubs were chasing your signature in the off-season. Why choose Glenelg?
The number one reason why I chose Glenelg is purely because it's a good club, and we haven't had much success either, so and that's something that we as players always want to strive towards, is winning a premiership. And it's been a long time since we won our last one, and we got a really good coach, and there was guys here that I knew and a good bunch of guys, so that was the most important thing. And for me and my football, the most important thing was to come out and have some fun, and I'm really, really enjoying it so far.
You feel with such a young, promising group here that something is building?
Yeah, absolutely. I think we've got a really good list, and if we can put it all together this year, we've got a great coach with a great game plan, and if we can get that right, I think we can win some games of footy this year, yeah.
Obviously, three seasons on West Coast list. What did you learn from your time over there with the Eagles?
Yeah, on and off the field. So, I mean, it's too much to narrow down to one thing, but I had a great time and absolutely loved it over there. And hopefully I can bring some real knowledge back to Glenelg and some of the younger boys out here, yeah.
What are some of those, I guess, knowledgeable things you can impart to the younger players, and perhaps what have you already been doing on the track with some of the guys?
Yeah, I think it's just probably standards and just thinking about your footy a bit more. Like, I remember when I was an 18-year-old, I didn't think about too much at all. So I was just thinking about it and how you go about it, what are you working on, how can you improve. So just those sort of things that I've picked up along the way, and just the finer details is really all it is. Everyone comes out here and has fun and enjoys it and works hard. It's just the fine-tuning, and, yeah, that's probably the main thing, yeah.
Well, Luke, thanks very much for your time on SANFL TV. All the best in 2019.
Awesome, thank you.
Thanks for joining us on SANFL TV, Corey. Some familiar faces around here, and no doubt pleased to put the black and gold on again.
Yeah, absolutely. It's always nice to come back to a team that you once played for, and yeah, there's still a few boys here that were here before, and yeah, it's good.
Obviously got to ask you about the foot. Had plenty of issues with it in your time at Geelong, but how's it been tracking, and in particular on the trial on the weekend against West Adelaide, how did you fare?
Yeah, it's going really well at the moment. It's had its hiccups here and there, but as every injury does, it's going well. So I played a quarter and a half pretty much on Saturday last week, which was good, and it pulled up really well. So just got a few more boxes to tick in terms of round one and getting up for that. But yeah, so far so good, which is nice.
So pretty hopeful for round one against Nord?
Yeah, I'm definitely hopeful, but I think the medical staff might be a bit different, but at the moment, yeah, just got to tick a few more boxes.
Obviously, we saw your time at Geelong playing predominantly small forward, half forward a little bit. What about your role here with the Tigers?
Yeah, I'd love to just get into the midfield a bit more as here at Glenelg. So if I can do that, have maybe a 70-30 between the midfield and forward, yeah, that'd be ideal for me. But yeah, I'm happy just to go wherever... Yeah, wherever's best for the team.
And you feel your skill set certainly complements Glenelg's midfield group, because initially they had a lot of hard nuts who sort of win that hard footy and farm it out, and you've got some nice skills to be used on the outside.
Yeah, hopefully, yeah. Our inside midfielders are really good, and they're really good at getting the ball. So if I can, get the ball off them and, yeah, try and hit a kick. But, I'm hoping that my skill set will be valuable to the club.
And plenty of run and carry, as you showed in that first ever league goal you kicked against South Adelaide.
That'd be nice to get another one of them. But, I'll just hopefully just get out in the park and just have a bit of fun with footy for once.
Thanks very much for your time, Corey. All the best in 2019.
No worries. Thank you very much.